Hello everyone, welcome to Twilight, Problem is Possibility, and this is Dr. Rajalakshmi. And I am here today to talk about or to do a series of lectures on endocrine disorders in the ICU, endocrine disorders in the critically ill patient. So I am going to start with thyroid, non-thyroid illness or sick thyroid. What is the definition of sick thyroid or non-thyroidal illness? Abnormal or alteration of thyroid profile without any primary disease in the gland. There will not be any problem with the gland per se, but if we do thyroid profile, the entire profile will be altered without any clinical manifestation of either hypothyroid or hyperthyroid. What are the expected alterations or expected abnormalities in the biochemistry? T3 will be definitely decreased, T4 decreased or normal. In spite of low T3 and T4, TSH will not be increased. TSH will be normal or slightly on lower side. Reverse T3 will be increased. Reverse T3 is one of the metabolites of the T4. T4 will be converted into reverse T3 and T3. Reverse T3 will be increased. T3 will be decreased in case of sick thyroid or non-thyroidal illness. What is the possible mechanism? In spite of extensive research, we could not figure out what is the exact mechanism behind this illness or behind this abnormal biochemistry. The proposed mechanisms, there can be alterations at different levels, at the level of transporters, at the level of metabolism of hormones in the cells, and at the level of receptors. The transporters available are MCT8. Monocarboxylase transporter 8, MCT10, and organic anion transporting polypeptide family C1, OAT, P1, C1. These are three transporters which transports T3, T4 to the cell, into the cells. In the brain, MCT10 and OAT, like monoorganic ion transport, organic anion transporting polypeptide family like MCT10 and OAT P1C1 will be increased in the hypothalamus. MCT8 does not change in the brain. Coming to liver, MCT8 expression will be increased in case of the prolonged illness, and MCT10 does not change. Coming to metabolism, the metabolism of hormones will be done by a group of enzymes called deiodinases, a group of selenium cysteine containing enzymes, and they will remove iodine atom from inner and outer ring of thyroid hormone. 1, 2, 3. 1 catalyzes both inner and outer ring deiodination, and 2 catalyzes only outer ring, converting T4 to T3, which is the active form. T3 or type 3 deiodinase catalyzes only inner ring, converts T3 into T2 or T4 into reverse T3. Overall, deiodinase 3 will inactivate the enzyme. Deiodinase 2 will cause increase in the availability of active hormone. T3 increased expression of T3 results in decreased bioavailability of active hormone. Increased expression of type 2 enzyme will cause increased bioavailability of active hormone. In hypothalamus, deiodinase 2 expression will be increased, type 3 enzyme will be decreased. So overall results in increased bioavailability of thyroid hormone. Coming to liver, muscle, neutrophils and macrophages, there will be differential alterations in terms of acute and chronic illness. Sometimes deiodinase type 2 will be increased, sometimes it can be decreased. So overall the net result will be the bioavailability of the hormone will be altered in all these end organs. Reduced hypothalamic TRH expression and portal serum TRH and pituitary TSH content have been observed in both non-thyroid illness patient. So basically there will be alteration of hypothalamic pituitary thyroid axis. TRH expression, thyroid releasing hormone expression, will be decreased, results in decreased TSH production from the pituitary. And some says this is This is been mediated by decreased or increased availability of local T3, which in turn caused by the increased type 2 DINS enzyme. And other mediators or other etiology behind decreased expression of the TRH will be glucocorticoids. High steroid level will suppress pituitary response to the TRH. What is the effect of nutrition on hypothalamic pituitary thyroid axis? Decreased food intake, starvation will cause decrease in the leptin hormone. This decrease in the leptin hormone in turn decrease the expression of the TRH in hypothalamus. Ultimately results in decreased TSH secretion and decreased thyroid hormone levels in the serum. So once we see it biochemistry, how to differentiate non-thyroid illness from overt hypothyroidism. As we discussed, in case of non-thyroid illness syndrome, there will not be any clinical signs of hypothyroid. Coming to chemistry, the clear-cut low T3, sometimes low or normal T4. Free T3, free T4 can be low or normal, but TSH will not be increased. In spite of low thyroid hormone, there will not be compensatory increase in the TSH because of alteration of hypothalamic pituitary thyroid axis. Coming to overt hypothyroid, if we are able to find positive anti-T2O antibody, that will support the diagnosis of overt hypothyroidism over non-thyroidal illness, and TSH will be higher, relatively high T3, T4 concentration, and reverse T3 will be low. In case of non-thyroidal illness, reverse T3 will be high. In case of overt hypothyroid, reverse T3 levels will be low. What are the drugs interfering with analysis? When patients in the ICU, the patient will be on many drugs which can interfere with the TSH concentration. For example, dopamine. Dopamine will inhibit the TSH release, in turn may decrease T3, T4 levels. Use of anticonvulsants, glucocorticoids can lower free T4 levels. So while interfering, understanding your report of thyroid profile, we need to consider the confounding factors like drugs, especially dopamine and anticonvulsants and steroids. High steroids can in turn decrease the expression of the TRH and in turn decrease the sensitivity of the pituitary gland to the TRH. Dopamine will inhibit release of the TSH. Overall, the net result will be decreased T3, T4 levels. Role of thyroxine in non-thyroid illness. Do we need to replace any thyroxine when T3 levels are extremely low? As of now, no role, but many studies have shown negative results, especially many randomized controlled trials have clearly shown that supplementing some thyroid, supplementing thyroxine in case of sick thyroid resulted in adverse outcomes. So as of now, there is no role of giving thyroxine when patient is having non-thyroidal illness. Some studies have shown that replacing gonadotropin releasing hormone, growth hormone and TRH to stimulate hypothalamic pituitary thyroid axis had resulted in some positive outcomes, especially in terms of the metabolic parameters. And some studies have shown improved hemodynamics, especially when patient is having heart failure and cardiogenic shock. But we need to have more randomized control trials to get more clarity about the role of all these hormones, TRH, growth hormone, and gonadotropin releasing hormone supplementation. What is the clinical significance? Sometimes it helps us to decide upon the prognosis. Persistently high level of reverse T3 and persistently low level of T3, T4 may indicate poor prognosis. Thank you, and I'll meet you soon. I'll meet you all soon with further topics on endocrine disorders in ICU. And the next topic will be myxedema pleura and thyroid dysplasia. Thank you.